Hi, my name's Chu, I'm from the Travelling Telescope, and I'm going to tell you about our bamboo dome. We work with schools, usually, not at the moment, but with schools we bring a big telescope and a big mobile planetarium to schools across Kenya, and we've been to Tanzania as well. Hopefully we can do more places. We've just been struck by the power that exposing kids to telescopes and astronomy, looking through the telescope and actually seeing craters on the moon or the rings of Saturn with your own eyes. It's not in a book, it's not on a screen, it's live. That has an amazing power to inspire kids to get into STEM subjects and hopefully become, you know, the problem solvers of tomorrow. So to that effect, we also felt that there was a strong need to have a We also felt that there was a strong need to have a permanent planetarium in Nairobi. So we started the Nairobi Planetarium after building using bamboo. Which was on our compound. We're in a place which we're renting, which has a big garden and had a huge bamboo plant. So we were looking at that and going, perhaps we could turn that into a geodesic dome. I'd never come across these things much before, but it was something that I was very passionate to use bamboo. Partly because one of the things we talk about in our planetarium sessions is how we need to be better stewards of the Earth, and so using resources that are locally available materials, fast growing crops like bamboo is incredibly fast. It's the fastest growing one of the fastest growing plants. I think even holds the record, one particular species. And it's much more sustainable than, for example, a hardwood tree, which is traditionally used for building purposes. You can get a mature bamboo culm, is what they're called, in about four or five or six years. So compare that to a couple of hundred years for a big old oak tree or a mahogany or something like that. We were very passionate to demonstrate to the kids and to the people that come and visit our planetarium that it's not just talking about it. We don't just want to talk about it, we want to demonstrate it and show that we can actually come up with solutions. Trying to, you know, think around the problems of, you know, using metal and importing resources from far away, and then lots of fabrication, industrial processes. So getting rid of that. So we just used bamboo and rope. It's pretty much all that the planetarium, the structure itself, is made of. We did then cover it with a waterproof fabric, which, yes, has been got some nylon in it, which is obviously not necessarily a sustainable resource, but we feel it's a good use. At least it'll last many, many years. Possibly, yeah, 100. So yes, we treated the bamboo because you kind of have to protect it against insects and mould. So there's a particular set of sort of environmentally friendly chemicals that you use to protect the wood, so that it's not attractive to bugs which like to eat it. And then started to make these. We came up with a brand new way of making the hubs. It's not necessarily perfect, but it does mean that it's totally made of bamboo. The central areas where the hubs kind of connect together, where the struts connect together, is made of bamboo as well. And we now have the issue of trying to make it COVID unfriendly, if you like. So we want to still be able to do planetarium shows. Now, a lot of planetariums across the world are closed, and that's mainly because they're sort of sealed environments. It's you block out the light because it's a projection system. So to get around that, what we thought we could have it opening at the sides and at the top, so that wind and air can get through it, and it's effectively it's like an outside cinema, an outdoor dome. So that the wind will be able to pass through it, so that we can minimise the possibility of transmission from COVID-19. That's our plan. So that's where we are at the moment. We are sort of redesigning bits and pieces of it. We're also going to put a much stronger material. We're going to put some extra bamboo on the roof, like using tiles, and that's so that we can use it during the day and run some of our other programs, which it's not just about planetariums, the ones we do. We also have robotics workshops and other using computer resources, having it a multi-function space. That's the new plan. So that's where we are now. We're in the process of developing a slightly different way to have it built, to build it. Have I missed anything?
Continue.
So one of the things that that really inspires us is when we visit schools, and some of them are very, very rural areas. In fact, today we're in quite a rural area, not visiting a school, is visiting some family. It's very powerful. When you have a kid, there was one kid that came up to us and said, I thought scientists would just make stuff up. It's like, how do they know? And he just had an experience in the planetarium, and we can go through how, because you can speed up time, for example, in a planetarium, you can really demonstrate how the sky moves, and that gets people to sort of understand it better. And I think that, if a scientist just says, oh, Saturn's got rings, you're like, well, how do you know? And then you can say to them, if you've got the telescope there, you can show them. And in the planetarium, you can obviously zoom even further in, much further in than you can with the telescope, and even talk about the moons that, that spin around. And so having that experience in the planetarium is very powerful, and I think it can inspire kids to get interested in science and to become the problem solvers of the future, and look at science in a it's demystifying it, I think is the word. So having that immersive experience, this kid had just been exposed to our planetarium, and he's like, I now believe in science. Not that you necessarily have to believe in it, but it's that that idea that science now makes much more sense. And we want to share that with as many people as we can. Obviously, with our travelling telescope and travelling planetarium, we will continue to do that. But having a fixed planetarium in Nairobi is vital, I feel, for the people of Kenya, for anybody in any part of the world. We're very lucky in the Western world to have lots of planetariums all over the place. I'm from the UK originally, and there are planetariums everywhere. Kenya doesn't have that. Kenya, what we do is with our traveling planetarium and telescope, it's probably one of the only organizations like it in the region. And so having somewhere that people can go and learn about space and space science, and it really is encouraging people to get into science, partly because at the moment we're very, very aware that COVID-19 is something which we rely on the scientists to inform us about. And so if you have people, and more people unfortunately are being led astray by non-scientific content online, we can have more people getting to understand why we need science. COVID-19 is a tiny little bug that that you can't even see. You need a scientific tool, a microscope, to be able to see that and to understand how it works, how it bonds, how it attacks the body. All of these processes are known about only through science, and so we need to encourage people to lure them in with the wonder of the universe, and then hopefully push them on to discover more about the scientific world. So thank you so much for letting me have this chance to speak to you about our project with the Bamboo Dome. I hope that we can, together, make the world a more sciencey place.